Ah, the heart of America's automotive success, where 16-year-olds have the widest selection of motorized vehicles to choose from thanks to the Ford Motor Company and the competition that was brought as a result. With the finest selection of vehicles to choose from, so that we as American citizens have an easier method of transportation to our sweat-inducing labor prisons, these motorized hunks of steel come with a catch. Accidents. Hi, I'm driving instructor Jerry Wiggins, talking to you today about driver safety. Today, we'll be observing two drivers, one good, one bad, focusing on their daily routines and the importance of what they do behind the wheel. Meet Wright. Wright is the happiest he can be, even on the worst of days. Wright has a couple errands to run, and luckily, it's a beautiful day to do so. Meet Ren Okoneoki Jen, or Wong for short. She's a Filipino female who came to America to seek out the American dream. Right now, Wong is leaving to work at her job at the dry cleaner. Here, we are going to follow both Wright and Wong on what they both do right and wrong. Driving is no easy task for the common citizen. There are about 15 and a quarter distractions that can occur while you are driving. This will be important as we demonstrate what you should and shouldn't do behind the wheel. Let's check on Wright. How Wright came to a screeching halt. He must have not been paying attention and almost rear-ended the car in front of him. That could have been bad. The driver in front seems to be not responding to Wright's horn. Wright must refrain from losing his temper, which can lead to road rage. I'm sure the driver in front will leave any
Will you get out of the fucking way? Someone has places to be!
Let's head over to Wong. Wong appears to be doing quite well. Notice how she has both hands on the wheel at the 10 and 2 positions. Look, she's even using her blinker. Wong is stopped behind someone, but she has nothing to worry about. She left the house about 1 minute early, so she could guarantee being to work on time.
So Noah, is this your first time behind the wheel?
It would appear so.
Well, I'm sure you already know the basics, so go ahead and turn the car on.
Alright then.
Oh, you like that, huh?
Oh, fuck! Just take it!
You dirty, dirty ho-
Wright seems to have gotten out of that fiasco back there, and now he's back on the road to get to his errands.
Whoa! Wright just broke the law! Just because you have places to be doesn't mean the law ceases to exist. Let's hope that Wright can correct this mistake. Luckily, a stoplight catches his attention. Wright seems to be locked in with the road, so that as soon as the light turns green, he lets off the brake and makes a smooth release on the gas pedal. Or he's avoiding making eye contact with the homeless person next to him. It seems to be that Wright doesn't care about those who are struggling financially. That's alright, there's no need to judge. But, of course, this person seems to be depending on the Good Samaritans of the city to lend a hand to the poor. I mean, all the money Wright earned is his to keep, of course, but you'd think that someone who's in the middle class could spare a... Speeding off of a light is a one-way ticket to getting a speeding ticket. Here comes Wong,
coming to a slow stop right before the line so that pedestrians, like me, can walk safely. The homeless man is still waiting for a crumb of change so that he can get some delicious brownies. Will Wong look into the kindness of her heart to lend a hand?
Alright, you seem to be doing pretty steady behind the wheel. That being your first time and all, I think you're doing pretty shitty.
Yeah. Is that a good thing?
Just keep your eyes on the road.
That will not be a problem. I won the state staring contest last fall.
Really? I doubt that, considering I've never heard of it. Besides, I don't think you'd go toe-to-toe with me.
Well, that's where you're wrong. With all due respect, Mr. Teacher.
Alright, I challenge you to a staring contest.
Wait, right now? Whatever happened to keeping my eyes on the road?
I mean, sure, we could wait. But I can't say for certain that you'll pass today.
Alright, you're on.
It's been a bit of a drive, but luckily, Wong made it to her job with no laws broken whatsoever. We'll check back with her later. Let's look over at Wright. Wright is in quite the rush to get his errands done. Remember, no matter how late you are, driving reckless is never the way to go. Oh, it appears that Wright is preoccupied. We'll have to come back to him later as well. Well, well, well. It appears our driver has been busy for quite a while. Hoping he's thought carefully about his mistakes on the way here and will correct them on the way back. It was also a pretty busy day at the dry cleaners for Miss Wong. It's important to be mindful that after a long day of work, you have to stay awake and 110% aware while you drive home in case you're drowsy and exhausted. Uh-oh! It looks like Wright hasn't been driving cautious enough on his way home. Wright is gonna have to pull over and find out what he did wrong.
Whoa now, it's alright my brother. Just a routine stop so I got something to mark on my papers. Can I see your license and registration?
In this situation, Wright must comply with the officer, for if he doesn't, he could lead to an arrest.
Yes, officer. Here's my totally real and legit license and registration.
Alright, looks pretty good to me. And just to make sure you don't have any illegal substances or weapons on your lap, I'm gonna ask that you please open your car door for a quick second.
Alright, I think you're all set. You are free to go.
Fuck you!
I love my job.
Seems that Wright got off pretty easy. Luckily, Wong didn't have to worry about any issues on her way home, as long as she follows the law.
God damn it! What did I just...
Oh darn. What could Wong have done that would have caught this officer's attention?
Excuse me, madam. Couldn't help but notice you were a woman driving.
May I ask, and it's okay if you don't know, but how fast do you think you were going?
I think I was going the speed limit, officer.
Oh, you lying bitch. Give me your license, you piece of shit. And your registration. Bitch. All right, I'm gonna need you to step out of the vehicle for me.
I never thought I'd be doing this, but I'm actually taking control of the road.
Yes, you are. You're doing a great job.
Really?
Of course. You're going to the speed limit, you're checking all your blind spots, and you're hitting every stop sign with precise care.
You know, I kind of wish my dad saw the signs to stop hitting my mom, but he doesn't care. But he was always precise with his hits, though.
Like this one time when I came home from school and my dad...
Yeah, just turn down the street right there. I need to stop at this house.
All right, then.
All right, I'll be like 15 minutes.
I think this is where my dad goes sometimes.
Done it for me, okay? Look,
what Wright is doing is very highly dangerous. Distracted driving, 9 times out of 9, results in an accident or even death. Allow a demonstration.
Yes, I changed the baby's diaper. No, the baby didn't. I'll bring him back when I'm ready, Deborah. This is still my weekend. Nothing's gonna happen to the goddamn baby.
Something is going to happen to this goddamn baby. Like jumping out of his arms. Now, here's a perfect example of what happens when you don't put the phone down and wait till you get home to talk to your wife about your impending divorce. 10 points!
Oh, holy hell, that! Not my baby. Not my...
Yikes. Roadkill. Even if you're not behind the wheel, you could still be in front of one if someone were to do exactly what Wright just did. Now, let's check in on Wong after her dispute with the officer. You see, Wong just avoided making matters worse for someone's baby by driving around. This is because Wong was aware of her surroundings because she wasn't on her phone, unlike Wright, who still has a lot to learn.
Jesus Christ!
Are you gonna fail me because of this? Please don't do that. I gotta get my license before I go to jail. I just can't do this. I can fucking do this.
All right, pipe down. No one's going to jail. Besides, this is good practice for the real world. Luckily, I know how to handle these situations. Just play it cool.
All right, sir. You mind telling me how fast you're going and why you have a fake student driver sticker on your bumper?
Sorry, officer.
Sir, there's a bomb in the trunk.
Nice try. That's the second time I've heard that today. Why don't you step out of the car?
Well... Why don't you get some bitches instead?
All right, wise ass, don't make me pull you out of the car myself.
Hey, is that an innocent black guy over there?
Where?
Step on it!
Ugh, I hate my job. But at least I'm still happily married.
After a long day of driving around and obeying the traffic laws, Wong is finally home and is ready to call it a day. There's a lot to learn from what Wong does right, and if you were paying attention, then you should have no problem when you begin driving on the road. And then there's Wright, who managed to do everything wrong. Wright is on his way to a short life if he continues to drive the way he does, and it's people like him you have to stay away from when on the road. A license is not a free ticket to do what you want. It's a privilege that requires the utmost care as an individual like yourself.
So now you want to come home after all this fucking time, not even say a fucking word to me, fucking ignore me, not tell me where the fuck you're going, I was resident, why the fuck? Thank you.
As for me, I was here to teach you the right and wrongs of right and wrong, and I hope I accomplished that. So, until next time, I'll see you on the road.
What the fuck are you doing inside my house?
I think I learned something today.
What's that?
That driving is an important responsibility to have, and it should be taken very serious in every aspect of your life. Thousands of accidents occur every year at the hands of careless drivers, and we as adults and teenagers need to do better behind the wheel. It also goes without saying that safety always comes first, and without safety, we will continue to...
Can we have sex?
Absolutely.